What is going on, everyone? Today, I wanted to make a video on where you can find legendary engraving books in Lost Ark. Now, if you have been living under a rock, where have you been? With the introduction to Tier 4, the legendary books have skyrocketed. Don't believe me? Let me show you. Ta-da! Now, I'm going to only be talking about combat legendary engraving books, like Raid Captain, Adrenaline, Keen Blunt, not the class engraving books. This is because class engraving books are going straight down the toilet in Tier 4. Don't believe me? Again, let me show you Deathblow books. They're 10 gold. Alright. Anyway, before we get started on our checklist, I must ask, have you subscribed yet? We are so close to that 10% number. Let's get more representation from the subscribers. Okay, on with the video. Now, the first place to check is the Legion Raid Exchange. If you are a veteran, you most likely claim this book already. It's all the way over here. Ta-da! Legendary Combat Engraving. But it doesn't hurt to check. New and returning players, definitely check, since there are so many things happening in Lost Ark and you could have simply missed it. So make sure you check the Legion Raid Exchange NPC. The second place you should check is the Solo Mode Exchange Shop. This is a new NPC that hasn't been out for too long, so everyone could have definitely missed it. So be sure to check if you claimed yours in the solo mode shop. And it should be found in the exchange tab. Yep, right here. Legendary combat engraving recipe. Alright. The third place to check is the Lights Trail Exchange. This is the Kyangel shop. Many people don't even realize that you can use these, Light of Victory, to get level 4 and level 5 gems every single week. So you should check here for those gems as well. But in terms of the combat engraving book, it's also right here. So this one is you're able to get class ones, but you can also redeem combat ones. Do not do class using these books, please. All right, the next. The fourth way to get legendary combat books is Chaos Dungeons. Now, it's not a guarantee, but you could get a nice surprise. So as you're doing your dailies, it's always nice to see that you get a good combat engraving book. I think in my lifetime, I've gotten 2 good ones. It's not very, you know, common, but it is a way. So just keep that in mind. All right. Number 5 is Abyssal Dungeons, but only 3 of them. So if you can see, for example, Ancient Elveria, and we scroll all the way down, there is a red exclamation mark sign indicating that you cannot earn any of these. Now, if you're a new player, you'll see something different, and maybe you're at this current item level, and these will be unlocked. But since I am a higher item level, I am unable to claim these. But as you can see, you can't redeem any combat books here. But starting in Oreha's Well, you'll see, boom, combat engraving and class. Well, we really more so care about the combat. Now, someone like me, I can't do Oreha's Well. As you can see, I can't redeem it no matter what. So I would have to start from Kyangel. So Oreha's Well, Kyangel, and finally Ivory's Tower are the 3 abyssal dungeons where you can get legendary engraving books. But again, it depends on whether it's actually available for you. If you're a new and returning player, look at if you have some characters in this 1370 range that can claim these combat engraving books. Otherwise, Kyangel and Ivory are the only abyssal dungeons that you can do. All right, Legion Raids. The most obvious one, I'm sure, but you should be doing them anyway, but gotta include it in the video. So unlike Abyssal Dungeons, all the way from Vaultin, you can see, let's scroll to the right here. Boom. combat engraving recipe. All the way from Vulton to Thamine, they all will provide you with the combat engraving recipe. So, if you have free time, the world is your oyster. Do these Legion raids as you see fit. All right. Number 7 is Kazaros raid. So it feels weird to separate Legion and Kazaros into two, because technically, you know, they're same bosses, but, you know, different raids. So the one and only Echidna in the Kazaros raid for now also drops legendary combat engraving books. So make sure you do Echidna's. I can't believe I have to say that. So anyway, let's move on to number 8. All right, number 8 is solo mode. Yes, even solo mode can give you legendary engraving books, but it is based on your item level. Okay, let me look at it in this section right here. Yep, right here. So you can see, similar to the Abyssal Dungeons, if you hover over here, there are certain item level restrictions for getting the loot. The, for Vulton's case, if 1600 or higher, you're unable to redeem the rewards. For Vicus, it is 1600. For Clown, it's 1610. For Belshaza, it's 1620. And at least for my level, I can do Kyangale, Akan, and Oldis. But for you, it could be different. You can have these available. So make sure you double check to see if you have the red exclamation mark on it. But just as an example, let's go on Kyangale, and you'll see it does give you combat engraving recipe. So, something maybe people didn't know, but yes, solo mode also can give you legendary books. All right, next is number 9, cubes. So, you probably knew this, but if you didn't know, yes, you can get legendary engraving books at the end of cube runs, but it is rare. I also would be saving cube tickets, but that's another story. Anyway, number 10 is Throne Spire, which is over here. So let me pause this video and I'll go over there and show you what I mean. All right, and we're back. And this is the Throne Spire. So there are multiple levels. It's very easy. As long as you know you have decent gear, you'll be able to clear it, no problem. But you will see as you get rewards, you know, this is a very good way to get silver. Silver guy coming soon, but you know, card XP is also here, cards are also here, but there is also 2 legendary combat engraving selection pouches. This is super nice. This was introduced to help us peasants back in the day get grudge books and lower the price of grudge books, as the price was absolutely ridiculous. So make sure you get these books here. Okay, number 11 is Rowan. I know, an annoying continent to do, but it does give legendary engravings. So you're going to have to do some quests there, get those the male blood pieces or whatever. And there's an NPC there. I'm not going to go over there and show it, but there, trust me, there is one there that you can redeem for a combat engraving book. So if you want to do that, more power to you. Go ahead and do that. Number 12 is Anguish Isle. So let's see where it is. It's right here. Right here. So this is an island located a little below Punica. I would highly recommend doing this island, but it definitely is a pain, because you got to do it every single day. Well, not necessarily every single day, but it's nice to do it every single day so you can, you know, collect enough to redeem it. So it's your choice, but it's another way to get legendary engraving books. All right, next. Number 13, Chaos Gate. Now this one is the absolute best, especially with the nerfs to it. Just a maximum of 2 minutes of your time for gold. You know, it gives you honing support mats as well, engraving books, etc. There's no reason not to do this. I think this is the most efficient thing to do in Lost Ark. Like, look at all these rewards you can get. Or at least for me too. Like, you can get all these types of rewards. No brainer. Definitely do your Chaos Gates. As you can see, combat engraving recipe does drop here. All right, next. Number 14, since we're in this UI, yes, I have to mention field bosses. I wouldn't recommend this one, especially because the odds of getting a good legendary book is rare. But desperate people have to know every single avenue. So there you go. Yes, field boss can, you can auction and bid for the legendary engraving book. But just know it's probably going to be a bad one. Anyway, finally, number 15, our last and final one. And it's probably the least recommended one, and I had to dig really hard for it, and that is rapport. And why I don't recommend this. So if we go over to rapport and reward info and scroll all the way down to engraving recipe, you will see this thing called honor combat engraving recipe. And if you complete up to, let's say, Nerea's amicable reward, you will get a chance of obtaining a following item. So not only is it a chance and not a selection pack, it also, unfortunately, gives you only the chance of getting a legendary to begin with. As you can see in here, it says can obtain one epic or legendary combat engraving recipe upon use. You'll probably get an epic. I have never gotten a legendary book from these, so do this knowing you probably won't get a legendary book. Anyway, those were 15 avenues that I can think of where you can get extra legendary engraving books. Now, there might be more, so if you can think of any others, I excluded stuff like express passes and stuff like that, just things that you can possibly get right now. But yeah, leave them in the comments. Otherwise, thank you all so much for watching. And, you know, don't forget to subscribe. Let's get to 10%. As a reminder, 10% gang, where are we at? But yeah, with that, I will end this video. Thank you all for watching. And I will see you all in the next video. Goodbye.